G'day, Tubes. How's she hanging? Not too good here. Holy cow. Oh, I've been like fairly horrifically sick over the last few days. As you can tell. Holy cow. Just slammed me one night there. I just wasn't feeling too good. Dylan got sick, I guess, from school. Brought her home. He was down for about 4 days or so. They're doing the same thing I'm doing here, which was pretty brutal. I don't know what kind of video I'm going to get for you today, but I have to go out and do some snow, I guess. Oh, man. It just produces like this really thick, thick, phlegmy stuff, and it's hard to get it out. You know what I mean? Oh, go away cold anytime. Holy cow. I can hardly talk. So there's not going to be too much talking, I guess, today. I don't know what we're doing. Probably not much. Oh, just can't get it out, eh? And then it ends up going down your throat and choking you, and not very nice. So we'll let that guy warm up a minute. I'm going to go get dressed, I guess, put lots of layers on, and we'll get doing some snow. I'll get doing some snow. It's kind of light snowing still out there, so I probably won't film it. But I don't know. I don't think I got anything else planned today, so after I do this snow, I might just head her home again. Oh, I got one thing I wanted to do. Oh, for you, if I can muster the energy to get it done too. But just today, it's better today than it was. At least my neck isn't sore anymore and stuff. Like, my neck was just like, oh, so tense, you know. And of course, the last two nights I haven't slept too well either. Well, that didn't help much, but it's still definitely in my face. Not so much in my chest now, which is good. Throat started off pretty good. It never really got sore. It only gets sore if I hack it really hard, you know. And so far, it's fairly moderate for runny nose and stuff, but after doing this out here, it's probably going to be pretty bad. So I'm going to probably take a couple of these with me. And then we'll go, I'll go out and do this snow. I'm going to get all wrapped up nice and warm and good and stuff. It's actually not bad out today. It's like -4. And yesterday it was, or the other day it was like -27 or -28. Oh, makes no sense. But anyways, let's just check that tractor here. Looks like she's all melted off again. Didn't sort of seem to really get that much water. Weird. So it must be evaporating it or something. Well, I guess a little bit must have ran out there. A little bit ran out, I guess, but now I got this urea here. I'll just shoot that out the door and then let her melt out there. So anyways, I wanted to do some messing around here with this machine, you know, the thumb, the new bucket we got built, ready to go, never used yet, but I just been down and out for the count. So one of these days, I think all we're going to be able to do with this bucket right now is go and play in maybe some snow or something. I don't know, we'll see. It might be good for using, you know, up the road kind of thing where the snowbanks are, if we had snowbanks. We haven't had much for snow really this year, so I really don't even have any snowbanks anywhere. So the only snowbanks I can kind of think of are just maybe along the side of the building here. Let's just have a look at the window. So I could have looked at the back door while we were there, but all right. there's some snowbanks there, maybe. I don't know. Usually this whole row of stones is buried in snow right beside the road, but right now it's nothing, so I don't know. It's weird. Weird. But anyways, there we go. So yeah, I'll go do that. I'll get dressed all up here and stuff, and I got one thing I wanted to do today for you, and that's probably going to be all honestly about it, because I haven't had hardly any sleep the last couple of days either, and tossing and turning, and then you get a big going in the middle of the night, and not been fun. So I've been done pretty good this year for not getting sick, and I could feel myself getting sick, so I was pumping in the cold effects pills, and I think it's helped a little bit, but it didn't do too much really. So I take kind of one in the morning and then two at night, and I think they have prevented quite a bit of me getting sick in the past, but this one just bit right in and gotcha. So but anyways, holy cow. So I'll go do my snow and catch you in a few, and see if I can do that. What I wanted to do for you, it's probably going to be like a fast time video thing, because it's going to take a while to do what I wanted to do, but yeah. So anyways, let's get at her. Okay, so it's one of those days where the snow just doesn't want to stop. Oh, man. So anyways, what my plan was today for you folks is it's going to be like a fasty time, kind of speedy up video, but some extra gas in the tank here. We're gonna run the, man, I got no energy either. We're gonna run the 130R here today with our sweeper and paddle attachment on it. Oh, one I've never tried it with snow before, so it'd be kind of interesting to see how that works. So this is the split shaft, as you know, and then we'll put the Dewey on the other end here, and it's been a while since I've had this thing running, so hopefully she'll fire up. Okay, so sorry, oh, oh man, sorry I got a bit of stuff in the way here, i.e. dumpster and snowplow. Well, we got a good chunk of the parking lot where I can film for you. Also, when I go up the side, I'm going to probably stop just past the dumpster here with this thing. And then when I go up the side of the building, I'm going to try using that thing too if it works. And I'll film it at the back door or something. At least you can see that part of it. But anyways, yeah, I could move the dumpster and stuff. But I don't know what. I really don't feel like it. Oh, sorry. So let's fire up here. Hopefully she starts. Okay, just before we start, I figure you might be interested in how this thing hooks together here. Oh, I don't even know if I got you in a good enough shot. I guess that's pretty good. Okay, so there's a little nib here and a little drive shaft sticking out. Sometimes they don't perfectly line up, but sometimes they do. And then here there's a little nib. You just put the nib on the nib, make sure she slides arrow to arrow. There's two arrows here. Tighten her up fairly good. Because if you don't, you'll be riding along, that thing will just flop out, and then zing! It's kind of funny. Okay, let's see, she'll fire up. Oh, we got the bristles on. Oh, pardon me, try first. Give it some priming. Good, and then we'll try right there on the parking lot. I don't know if I'm going to like this as much as the paddle. Okay, well, that wasn't really a whole lot of fun, especially when you're not feeling super great, maybe about 40%. I know the brush is a lot harder on the user, so we're going to switch to the paddle, but I'm willing to bet this won't scrape off very good. Those things, they rip down pretty nice. But these paddles probably won't work very good on snow. I'm willing to bet. And I got one other thing that we could try. And honestly, I've never had any luck at all with the last attachment that could be used for snow. But anyways, let's go try out here. Okay, so there's the other attachment I was thinking of. It's not as good as you'd think, though, honestly. Leaf blower. Now let's hook that up. There we go. And snow's weird because it's, when it's nice and light and fluffy, it's not too bad, but then snow gets packed together and it's not so good. This thing does blow a lot of air, but. Okay. Let's try around some stuff that I haven't messed with. This is probably going to be that square over here. A little bit. That's not working too much at all. That's not good because there's a little layer of, it was a little bit of freezing rain last night, so it's kind of hard to see, I know, but there's a layer of stuff there that would normally get swept off. So that's not too good. I think I'm gonna finish her off with the tractor here. I think that's probably going to be about it for today. After rolling around on the ground like that, I shouldn't have probably done that because it's really made my head feel bad now. One of them days, I guess. Oh, well, I've done pretty good so far through the winter to try to keep myself not getting sick, but this one got me. Wham! There you go. Have fun with it. Thanks a lot. So, I wanted to, well, not today, but I wanted to look up here. Maybe pull off this fascia board here on, this is the old part of the garage, woo, and this is the part that they added on. Now what I'm having a problem with is I've blown insulation, as you know. If you didn't see that video, look back a bit further under I can't remember what it was called, but blowing insulation in the top there, rented the machine from Home Depot, fed the bales in and started filling this above my shop here where all the heat is getting. There was nothing above there, right? So we did all that, but I did fill it up as much as I possibly could up this peak here. So it is probably about to this board here, maybe kind of thing, and then down and then right in the corner real good. But there's a spot where the heat's going out here, so it's going underneath the soffit here and fascia board and soffit and stuff, that I'd like to maybe pull this fascia board off and have a look in there and see if there's anything I can do, rather, you know, other than spray foam. I'm thinking might be the best idea in there, just to, you know, then filler that whole cavity maybe and cover it in there. But I don't really know 100% what's in there yet, because I haven't had it off. So see what's happening is the heat's coming in here, but it's going through those boards and then out, and then out this old style of roof. So it's actually going up in the old attic there and out. Now the only reason I know it's doing that, hang on a sec, and the only reason I know it's doing that, the heat's going right up through, hitting the old part of the roof, frickin' snow, is because it's melting. It's melting the snow off there. You can see it's all wet. So that heat's coming through this fascia board. There's the actual outside. So it's going through and then hitting that attic and then melting it. So I'm losing an awful lot of heat through that. And even there, somehow it's getting through too, around this corner, unless there's just actually no snow hitting there, but it is wet there too, right here. So I think I need to get under there. It looks like the heat's not getting too much past, like a foot past the wall, so. Oh, it's gonna be a messy, stupid job, and I don't really know how to insulate that properly. Probably batting would work. You could maybe take this fascia board off and stuff bats in. Now I'm trying to think, this roof will have beams going, joist beams going that way. So you might fill the first cavity, but I'd really like to pull off one of these boards and have a look in there just to see what's going on. Maybe I'll try that today. Now this one they probably didn't cut, so it's probably going all the way through, but I could probably do a cut right there and then be able to get under there and pry. Looks like they've got her nailed pretty darn good. There's two nails there, two nails there. So there's lots of nails, but that's definitely where a lot of heat is escaping there, unfortunately. And it's probably letting cold in there too, maybe. I don't know. I'm gonna maybe just grab my ladder off the wall here, see if I can get up there and have a look. See what's going on. I don't know, it's ticking me off. I really don't feel like it today, but I'd like to try to get that fascia board off without wrecking it too, but I don't know if that's gonna happen. And of course I also got a nice line for my door control going right up, and it goes out then to the dewey there, so I have to watch that too. Pull the staples off maybe and try to get it floppy enough that I can get that board out and just have a look. I think that probably, unless it's gone rotten or dry rotted, that whole board will probably come off. But anyways, I'm gonna grab the ladder and just lean it up somewhere here maybe and have a look. Well, just having a look up here. It's definitely warm up here. When they redid my insulation here too, wow, I missed a big gap there. Holy crap, dude, really? They glued all this plastic on here, but they definitely didn't use the right glue, because it's all pulling off already. Wow. And I kind of think when they did this addition here, they probably should have pulled these shingles off the old part of the roof here. And that's kind of chintzy, because now they're going to go all weird and then have a big gap there, and I'll have to seal all that up. Definitely looks like that glue didn't hold to anything though. It's not the right stuff they used, I guess. I think all I used was construction glue. That didn't work. So, I guess, look at this, like up here. Like, these guys were new at this, I think. Like, really, can we not have people in this country that know what the hell they're doing with insulation? Like, even I know that's not right. Holy cow, you don't leave like a 6-inch gap and just smash it the hell in there and just leave it. And up in there, that's an air leak gap there. I don't know, whatever. Guess I figured out just a garage, who cares? Well, I care when we gotta pay for the heat. But this looks like she's on there pretty decent. Yeah, it didn't stick there at all. Stupid. Now I got a saw I could maybe, like a hand saw if I can get there and maybe saw through that, I don't know. But I'm really not kind of feeling like doing that today. Yeah, I don't know what to say. I gotta get this line off of here, which doesn't look like it's gonna be hard now because there's no glue hole, nothing. Half the staples didn't get in where they were supposed to. Wow. So, they probably shouldn't have used construction adhesive glue. They should have used that because it's just like as smooth as the plastic there now. They should have used some kind of silicone stuff, I would imagine. But what's going to happen here again is all my insulation is going to turn that black color again, and it's not from mold, it's from this stuff being like an air filter, because it's going to suck the dirty air, like when I start the tractor up, open the door, it's going to blow air through the door and then up, come in these cracks, it's going to suck up the dirty air, then it gets sucked through the inside of this insulation to where it's going to go out, and then it just acts like a filter. Traps all the dirt, so lots of fun, but these aren't in too much of good shape here, really. Wow, crumbly. I just wondered what they must have put flashing on the outside to prevent the water from coming through here, because you would think it would penetrate through that pretty easy, and I've never seen water here, so I guess they done that part of it right. And there's actually the old roof there. The old plank roof. That's how old this garage is. It looks like two layers of shingles on here too, maybe. That was the color, I guess, green at one time. Wow. Welcome to the 60s. Yeah, that heat will be just going right through these holes here, whatever, you know, and penetrate through these holes real easy. Big hole there where they run the wire through. Oh, but that's what I'm thinking, if I can pull this board off. Which might not be too bad, I don't really know. If I can get under there and pry it. Get in there and stuff some batting in, or I do have that container of spray foam too, which I could get in there and maybe just let it do its thing until I get to the the edge here, and then put that fascia board maybe back on if it doesn't get wrecked coming off. But that's not going to be today because I really don't feel like it. Sorry. That'll potentially be on a warmerish day outside. Oh, when I can spray that stuff. This is it here. I don't know if I showed you that or not. My nice Pepsi Cola can. There's my handsaw. So I should be able to cut through that stuff there between the outside and the inside. So that's it there. Let me get her down. We'll have a look inside. Of course, it weighs 29.22 pounds. Why wouldn't it? Okay, we'll just have a quick look at this and then I think I'm gonna bail. So I gotta use this by March 20th, 2016. It says, I guess, the chemicals go unstable and explode or something. I don't know. I think that's just a thing that, oh, I better use that up so I can use it up and then buy another one. So I haven't actually had this thing out. You get a pair of safety goggle doohies. All your instruction thingies. 3 temperature checks. Chemicals, 70 degrees and above. Surface has to be 60 degrees and above, and the air temperature has to be 60 degrees and above, or you won't get it. Filling rate. Use in cold conditions produces undesired results. I'll show you that in a sec. Look at this thing first. So it gives you a bunch of spare nozzly, injectory nozzly deweys here, which is kind of neat, so you don't have to use them all at once. And it's really cool how they how these things work. I'll show you that after two, actually. So you get a whole bunch of them, and basically there's your kit inside. It doesn't actually come out of the box. You punch the handle out here, and then you just keep it in the box. Turn both things on. They're little miniature sized propane tanks, if you can see that in there. Kind of sweet. And then you get, 3 miles of hose here, and the gun, which the two lines come into the gun. I'm not going to squeeze it because I don't want it to explode on me. Put your nozzle on, and then I'll show you what the nozzle does. It's pretty sweet. Let's just push this out of the way and we'll have a look at these nozzles. So both lines feed into there. Woo, woo. So you can see the mixing thingy there, and then it heads down here in like a spiral. And that's where it actually mixes the two together. And then it comes out the end. And as you spray it on, by the time it gets down through here, it's all mixed. And then you spray it on, and it's like, what the heck? There's nothing going on here. And all of a sudden, I can't remember the ratio, I think. I can't remember. It's in the book there. There's your undesired results. Product shrinking back due to cold surface temperature. Amber runny liquid indicates an off ratio mixture between the two components. Product not fully expanding due to cold chemicals in the box, or lack of flow from a component. Component A. So you got an A and a B there. I presume it tells you that somewhere. I don't know. I think it did, actually. Do not over tighten. Yeah. So I guess they do it this way. Then, if you shut these off, your stuff and your lines won't harden until it gets mixed, but then basically this thing is junk. That's why they give you like 50 of them. Well, 6 of them, 8 of them, 10 of them or something. Some sweet, what is this stuff for? Oh, that goes on the dewy, I think, in here or something. I can't remember. I'd have to read it all again. It's all in the book here. So that's your undesired stuff, so you gotta make sure you do it in the right temperatures. I can't remember now. This thing actually came with a DVD too, and I actually have it up at the house. H229 is a pressurized container and may burst if heated. But anyway, that's all the instructions, and I have to flatten them out again. I know what I'll do, hang on. There, we'll put that 29 pounds to good use. Squish my books flat again. But anyways, we're a long way off from really doing that yet. Hopefully I can do it before March 16th. Or whatever they said there. March 2nd, 2016, I got a user by. Holy crap. I'm pretty sure it'll still be fine, but I don't know why they put a date on it. It was probably 3/4 of the way expired when I bought this kit like 3 months ago, whatever it was. But anyways, yeah, there we go. So that's kind of, how buddy's doing it. So deal for rim joists and crawl spaces, because you can just, well, that's definitely smaller than a crawl space where I'm going. So up there, that's what I'm after. Fire resistance even, nice. There we go. So you're probably wondering, why the heck are you going to all this effort and work just to seal that up? Well, like they say, every little bit counts, or every little bit helps. Everything is still like a block wall here, so it's hard to heat a block wall. I mean, gotta try something, you know. If I can get that furnace to turn off one extra cycle per hour, that would even save a lot, but pretty much need to get that, they call it styrofoam. I think it's called styrofoam SM here in Canada, and it's 2 or 3 inch thick, like rigid foam. And I'd like to do that whole entire wall back here with it. And that would probably really make a huge difference. But then, you know, I got the outside walls. I got, the garage door and then the other outside walls. So I'd have to probably spend, like, that stuff's not cheap either. I'd probably have to spend, oh, I don't know. I don't know how much it is really a sheet, but it's expensive. But I would say to do all this, because it's only about 2.5 or 2 foot wide by, I think, a 10-foot sheet. And I don't know how much they are here. I'll have to look it up on the Depot website. But, God, I would need a lot. Then you got to secure that to the wall, too. I think they get nailed on or something, or glued on. I guess construction glue. I don't know. I don't know what the best way would be to do that. But that would be expensive. And I don't know. It's not really my decision for that, so, you know, I can suggest it, but you'll probably get a, no, no, we're not doing that. Okay, well, you'd rather pay, you know, 3 times as much as you really should be on heat. That's fine, whatever. For heating the place, heating back there. Because you got to have somewhere to go after you're freezing cold and working out here. You got to have somewhere warm to go, you know, so. But anyways, I got to go do some shoveling over there, too. Anyways, that's it for today, boys and girls. Sorry. Folks, we'll say, I got a video coming up for tomorrow for you, is where we dissected, did a bit of work on the sweeper brush there. That was a few days ago. I did that video, just haven't posted it yet. But as for the cold stuff happening here, I'm gonna probably take myself a couple of few days to get over this, so you may not see much in the next couple of few days, unless I miraculously heal myself like I got the thing as I got sick. So, oh, it's horrible. Cold sock. Oh, and everybody's got it now. Flu going around everywhere. Oh, not fun. But anyways, thanks again for watching. Have a good day. We'll catch you. I don't know. We'll catch you when we can catch you, I guess. So, yeah, but tomorrow I'm going to do the tearing apart video there. I found some parts on that sweeper that, well, not necessarily the sweeper part. Well, yeah, a little bit of the sweeper part. More or less the lift part that needs replaced, so we'll do that tomorrow for you. And just to let you know for today that I'm going to be gone for a little bit because of this cold. Oh, it sucks. I might as well go rest my head. And you guys have a good day. And we'll catch you when we're hopefully mended.
All right, well, I'm just looking at this stuff on Home Depot's website, and they have, look at the price of it, eh? Woo-hoo. Now, mind you, that's about the thickest stuff, the widest stuff, and they're all 8-foot boards. So, $62.26, and they don't actually claim a whole lot of R value, surprisingly, per inch. It's a 5 R value per inch. So this stuff is 2 inches six. You'd only have an R10 value, which isn't too bad, I guess, for 2 inches thick. But that's 48 inches thick, which would work to 4 feet wide by 8 feet long. So I wouldn't need a whole lot of those sheets, but oh man, $62.26 each. Oh. Now they have other boards here too. Pretty much go by the size. That's another 48 by probably, I didn't actually tell me the measurements there, but it's either $8. Okay, that's good. But, half inch thick. So that'd give you like an R2.5. They say R5 per inch. That's a half inch, so 2.5 R value, that's pretty much wasting your time, that is. The only thing this would be good for is to put a layer of that first and then a layer of the other stuff, then you'd be real good. But, yeah, that's kind of crappy, so they got other stuff here too. Oh, save. I don't know if all this is in stock, though. They probably don't stock at all. But I guess it's what you're looking to get done, right? If you want an R value of whatever, well... Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what to say. What are these ones? I wouldn't be interested in 24-inch. I don't think stuff I'd want to go 48. So 48 by... It's a 1-inch... by inch, 1-inch... So that stuff's 1-inch thick, so it's only an R5 value. That's really not very much. So, yeah, I don't know what to say. Probably not going to do too much about it, but might be even not too bad of an idea to give that a spray foam, maybe. I don't know. You could spray foam that whole entire wall pretty easy, too. They did show those up here, I think it was. Yeah, there's the kits there. Look at the price on the way. That kit I got down there was $350. Yeah, that's right. And this one, which is like a 20-pound propane tank, $786. Man, that adds up pretty quick. But that would give you quite a few board foot, I would say. Good for large projects where higher yield provides greater economy. Yields up to 600 board feet of coverage, so that's not too bad. Doesn't exactly tell you there how thick, but I think that's that 1-inch thick. So, yeah. But anyways. Oh, insulation. You can never get enough, I'll tell you. Anyways, have a good day. We'll catch you later.